In today's video, we're going to take a look at some basic color correction using color wheels. Hey guys, what's up? My name is Serge, and welcome back to my channel for another tutorial video. Apple's last major Final Cut Pro update, 10.4, introduced some long-awaited advanced color correction tools like color wheels and color curves. These tools allow for much more precise and efficient color correction previously only available by installing plugins. In this video, we'll take a look at using color wheels and go through basic color correction workflow. First, let's set up Final Cut Pro for color correcting. We shouldn't need the browser, so let's hide it by pressing Ctrl+Command+1. Next, let's bring up our video scopes by pressing Command+7. In the inspector, select Color Inspector, and from the drop-down menu, select Color Wheels. At the end of this video, if you prefer using color wheels instead of color board, I'll show you how you can make this your default color correction tool. The color wheels give you the same control as the color board, but instead of having to flip through three separate tabs, all the controls are on the same screen. You have four different color wheels, just like we have pucks on the color board. There's a master wheel, and one for shadows, highlights, and midtones. On the right side of each wheel is an exposure wing, and on the left side is saturation wing. Let's use these wheels to color correct our clip in our timeline. First, to adjust exposure, let's switch to the Luma waveform in video scopes. From the scope drop-down menu, make sure waveform is selected, and select the Luma channel. This waveform horizontally represents our image, with 0 on the waveform being black on our clip, and 100 being white. So first, let's use the exposure wing on our shadows wheel to bring them down close to 0. We don't have many true blacks in our clip, so the waveform shouldn't go right down to 0, just close. Now let's bring up the highlights close to 100 by moving the exposure wing on the highlights wheel. I'll also bring down midtones a little to balance out the image. You may have to go back and tweak the shadows again just to get the waveform back down close to 0. Next, let's look at our saturation. When adjusting saturation, I always start with skin tones and then do the rest of the image. Our subject's skin is looking a little bit pale, so let's start by bringing up the saturation on the midtones wheel. Drag up the saturation wing until the skin color looks more natural, right about there. Let's also bring up the saturation in the shadows for richer blues. The highlights look good, so we'll just leave them. And last, our clip has a bit of a blue color cast to it. If we switch to the RGB parade waveform, this is very apparent. This seems to be affecting the entire image, so we'll use the master wheel to fix it. Grab the color puck in the middle of the wheel, and since our image has a blue cast to it, let's push it away from blue. Keep an eye on your image in the viewer and the waveforms while dragging the color puck until our image is nice and balanced. Let's take a look at our clip before and after a color correction. So, what do you think? You guys like using color wheels better, or do you prefer the color board? If you prefer color wheels and want to make it your default color tool, open Final Cut Pro's preferences by using the keyboard shortcut Command, comma. Now, in the bottom of the editing tab, from the default correction drop-down menu, select color wheels. Next time you open the color inspector, color wheels will be your default correction tool. Let me know in the comments below what your correction method of choice is, color board or color wheels. Or do you prefer the much more advanced color curves? Which, by the way, I'm making its own video about, and it's coming soon. If you haven't yet, make sure to hit the subscribe button and turn on notifications so you don't miss it. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you back here next week.